Hi, I'm Becca.
And I'm Brett.
And this is cdstv. Attention Academic Award recipients. The list of those who received academic awards have been posted in your classrooms for the past few weeks. Now you can pick up your academic letters, awards, and certificates from the principal secretary beginning Monday, April 26th through Thursday, April 29th from 7:15 a.m. through the end of both lunches. The awards will not be available after the end of fifth lunch or after school.
Attention juniors, it's time to start thinking about college. If you are interested in information about ASU, come meet with Janelle Leach, our ASU representative, today during both lunches in room EO53. College will be here before you know it, so start planning.
The last day to register for first session summer school is today. Visit the guidance office to pick up the summer school brochure. Remember, the last day to register for first session summer school is today.
And now for some 5-second films.
Hey Aztecs, nobody will believe in you unless you believe in yourself. Ask your teacher what that means.
Hey Forbes, what's that mean?
It means you're adopted and no one loves you.
So you all know that Market Week is next week between the 26th and the 30th, right? Well, you should come to both lunches because everything in the cafeteria you see here is a bit overpriced. You should come to Tat Snack Stand right here at the cafeteria. Everything here is only going to be 50 cents. You should be here both lunches.
Oh, man.
Did I hear trouble?
Yeah, I forgot my girlfriend's birthday present.
Seeing the Incredible Engraver's here. Check this out.
That's perfect. Thanks, Incredible Engraver.
All in a day's work.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, this is perfect.
Come visit me next week at Laser Tag during fifth lunch all next week, and on Wednesday, both lunches, where you can fulfill your engraving needs.
Weren't those great? Prom 2010, Lost in Atlantis. Tickets are on sale in the bookstore for $80 a couple. Be safe, be smart, and make good choices.
All Unity leaders for next year from 2010 to 11, please stop by Miss O'Malley's room, EO97, for an important flyer.
Come see the last main stage show of the year, the dark comedy, Chemical Imbalance, a Jekyll and Hyde play, tonight and Saturday night at 7 p.m. in the auditorium.
I know so much about movies.
Man, you don't know Jack.
Hi, I'm Jack, and this is You Don't Know Jack About Movies. Okay, we got no time to waste. Since yesterday we talked about some of the most anticipated films of summer 2010, we're going to look at some decent recent DVD releases. First up is the Blu-ray release of Toy Story 1 and 2, the two classics from Disney and Pixar. Blah, 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 they changed the face of animation. We know these films are classics, and we probably all see them, so this is just going to be a review of the Blu-rays themselves. Okay, first off, this is the best looking and best sounding version of the two films you will ever see. Have a good TV and a good sound system, you're in for a ride. But wait, what if I don't have a Blu-ray player? Well, if you have a PS3, you're ready to go, but with all Disney Blu-rays, a DVD copy of the film is included. So not only are you getting two great films in the highest quality possible, you're getting them with a bonus DVD copy. Sounds like a good deal to me. Next up is the Twilight Saga New Moon. The sequel to 2008's Twilight, aka
one of the worst films of the entire decade,
continues the story of Bella and Edward Cullen, the worst vampire in human history. Like the first one, the film fails because it is a terrible, 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 terrible romance. But it is a great comedy. Rent it if you need a good laugh. Notable releases include Sherlock Holmes, an okay action film saved by two excellent performances by Robert Downey Jr. and Jude Law, and the Lord of the Rings trilogy has finally hit Blu-ray in glorious high definition, but they're not the extended cuts, so frankly, who cares? Well, that covers about March and early April, but what about anything recent? Well, that's why I'm here. Just yesterday was the highly anticipated DVD and Blu-ray release of James Cameron's mega blockbuster Avatar. Whether you loved every second of The Great Adventure on Pandora or just couldn't stand it, pretty much almost everyone has seen this film, and pretty much everyone has a definitive opinion of it. I liked it, but I admit the script is flawed and some of the characters archetypical. But the visuals are absolutely gorgeous, and the action scenes are impressive set pieces. It's worth checking out, but whether you like it or not is solely up to your taste in film. Well, that's all about all the time we have for You Don't Know Jack. I hope you check out some of these films. I'm Jack Dooley, and I leave you with this. That song was so beautiful.
What a guy. Attention students, come and get your car washed tomorrow between 8:30 a.m. and 2:30 p.m. at the Speedy Quick Stop on Elliott and McClintock. All donations support Tempe Sister Cities.
Any NHS junior interested in applying for an officer position can pick up an application in EO52 or in the guidance office. All applications are due today.
Do you think your pet is the cutest at Corona? Starting today, bring a picture of your pet and $2 to Mrs. Bader's room in EO84 or to any Furry Friends Club member. The winner will be judged on CDSTV and will win the WestCar gift card. All proceeds will benefit local animal causes.
And now it's time for Corona, what you know.
Hey Corona, I'm Becca Dunham, and I'm going around the school asking students some trivia questions with a little twist in the end. So Corona, what you know?
Who was Joe Biden?
I don't know. Don't really care.
I don't know.
Our vice president?
Vice president.
Who was on the $20 bill?
Andrew Jackson.
Hamilton?
Some guy named Jackson, I believe.
Which president is Benjamin Franklin?
First.
Number five?
Didn't he invent the light bulb?
No,
he wasn't a president, right?
How many months have 28 days?
One,
February.
12.
All of them?
Which is heavier, a pound of feathers or a pound of bricks?
A pound of bricks.
They're each a pound.
They're the same.
Is it legal for a man to marry his widow's sister?
No.
I have no idea. Yeah.
No, because he'd be dead.
Good job.
Give me liberty or give me
death.
The King of Hearts? Oh, dude, what the?
King without a what?
Not a guess?
No. Oh my god.
I don't know. Who is that?
All roads lead to
heaven.
What?
Somewhere?
Good job, Brett. Didn't know you were so smart. Hey, Corona. FCA meeting is Monday night at 7 p.m. at Trevor Allen's house. Everyone is welcome.
Come support boys volleyball by eating at YC's Mongolian Grill Monday night from 5 p.m. to 8 p.m. Ask any JV or varsity player for a flyer. A flyer must be present at the time of purchase. Go Aztecs!
Any girl that wants to play basketball during the summer, there will be an informational meeting on Tuesday, April 27th, after school in Coach Strom's room, EO67.
Students, sports physicals for next year are being offered on May 1st for $25. 40% of the money goes back to Corona. Contact Scott Mason at 752-8865 for details.
Spring football begins Monday, May 3rd. Students must have a current sports physical on file in the athletic office to participate. See Mr. Nero if you are interested and have not played a sport at Corona during the 2009-2010 school year.
Well, Corona, I'm Brett.
And I'm Becca.
And this is CDS-TV.